Today we're going to look at setting up user accounts and permissions in ValveLink Software version 13.1 or newer. ValveLink Software now uses Windows login information in order to identify individual users or groups of users without the need to set up individual usernames and passwords. I've already installed ValveLink Software on my PC, and that automatically sets me up as an admin for this account. However, additional admins can be added if needed. Go to the Windows Start menu and type in Local Users and Groups. When the window opens, select the Groups folder, and at the bottom, select ValveLink Software Admins. A list of current admins for the local machine is listed. You can add or remove admins as needed to this account. With admins set up on the PC, we can now add users and permissions to access ValveLink Software. When you open ValveLink Software, no username or password information is required. Instead, it's using the Windows login information from the PC. Here you can see I'm logged in using my Windows username, I'm the admin for the account, and I currently have read-only permissions. If I want to add additional users to this account, I can go to Customize ValveLink, select Users and Groups, and then go to Add. This is a network PC, so I can search for individual users and groups of users on that network by selecting object types. I'm also able to identify the network locations in which I want to search to try and find those users. To add an individual user, I'm going to type their name into this field and select Check Names. It found the individual user, and by selecting OK, it adds them to Users and Groups. If I want to add a group of users, it's the same process, I just need to type in the group name instead. Individual users are identified by this icon, whereas groups of users can be identified by this icon. Details about the members of a group can be viewed by selecting Member Details, which displays a list of members for the group. ValveLink Software users can also be added to a local machine that may not be on a network. Go to the Windows Start menu and type in Local Users and Groups. When the window opens, select the Users folder, and under More Actions, select New User. In this window, you can create the account information that's needed to set up a new user. When you select Create and close this window, the new user is added to the user list. Open ValveLink and go back to Customize ValveLink, Users and Groups. To add the new user to the Users and Groups list, select Add, and this time, instead of looking on a local network to find the user, we only need to look on the local machine. Type in the name of the user that you just created. When you select Check Name, the user is found, and you can select OK to add them to Users and Groups. Permissions can be set by selecting the individual user or group of users and then selecting the permissions you wish for them to have. Currently, I can see that I only have read-only permissions. By unchecking the read-only box, I now can go through and select the permissions that I wish to have while using ValveLink Software. Follow the same steps to set the permissions for a group. Note that the permissions of an individual will override the permissions of the group. Also, if an individual is a part of multiple groups, the permissions are cumulative. For more information about ValveLink Software, visit fisher.com/ValveLink or contact your Emerson local business partner.